How to backup EC2 instance? If not, this video tutorial will help you how to take backup of the EC2 machine. Hi YouTube family, my name is Vicky, and if you are new on my channel, make sure you do subscribe my channel and hit the bell icon so that you will get notification of the new videos. Before we start the demo, let me tell you what exactly we need in this video. We need the EC2 machine, we need to create a EC2 machine, we need AWS backup service and IAM permission we need. And I will go step by step in this video. If you want to follow along, you can also do that. And if you have any doubt or concern, you can mention it in the comment section and I will reply to you. So not wasting much time, let's start with the demo. Before I start with the demo, let me tell you a little bit about the AWS backup service. So what exactly the AWS backup service is? So AWS backup service help us to take the backup of the resources in the AWS. It is not supporting all the resources for now, but there is a list of services which it is supporting right now. So we need to, you know, select one of those services which is currently supported by the AWS backup service. So in today's demo, we are going to take the backup of the EC2 machine. We are going to delete that machine and we are going to recreate that machine with the help of the AWS backup. So let me go to the console and let me show you how exactly we can do that. Let's start with the part one. In part one, we are going to create a EC2 machine. So how to create an EC2 machine? Right now I'm in North Virginia. So if you are following along, so what you need to do is you need to select the same region. So I'm in North Virginia and here I will go to the EC2 console. Now I'm in the EC2 console. So what I need to do is here I need to create one machine. So for that I need to click on the instance and I need to click on the launch instance. Now this is a new console. I don't want to go with the new console. So let me click on opt out and let me create a machine from here. And for this demo, I'm selecting the first machine from the Amazon Linux AMI. I'm going with the default option. The only thing which I need to mention it here is the tag backup machine. Let me give demo as well. We need to add couple of more tag here, but that is something I will do later on so that you can understand how to mention the tags. Configure security group, that is okay. I will go with the port number 22, review and launch, and let me select one of the key pairs. So okay, let me create a new one. Let me download this thing and let me click on the launch instance. Now the step one is complete. So we have created a EC2 machine and we are going to take the backup of this EC2 machine. Now the next part of this video, we need to go to the AWS backup service. So what we need to do is we need to type backup here. Now once we type the backup, we will get the AWS backup and we need to open this one. So I have already opened it in a new tab. So the AWS backup dashboard. So on the left hand side, I have couple of options like dashboard, backup vault, backup plan, protected resources, job settings. So let's go in each of these parameter one by one. So in order to create a backup, what we need to do is first we need to create a backup plan. Now how to create a backup plan? For that we need to go to the backup plan and we need to click on create backup plan. Now here we have three options. We can select the existing template which is created or which is provided by the Amazon. We can define a plan using the JSON or we can build a new plan. So for this, what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this option, build a new plan. Now here we need to give a name. So test backup plan. Now here I can add the tag, but I'm not going to do that. Backup rule name, so test rule. Now this option is for the backup vault. So what we need to do is we need to create a new backup vault. So let me give a name, test vault, and here it is giving me the option to select the KMS key. Now this is totally my choice. If I need to go with the KMS key, I can go with that. If don't, I can leave this option. Now, what exactly the KMS or the encryption key here? It is going to encrypt my data. So I'm going to select the default one. So let me create this thing. Create backup vault. Now the backup frequency is going to be on the daily basis. I'm going to leave this option. Use backup window default. Now transition to the cold storage. I don't want to do that. Retention period, I want to go for 1 day only. Copy to destination. Now let's suppose if I need to copy this backup to some other location or to some other AWS account, I can also do that by going to this option. I can add the tag here. If I need to take the backup of the Windows machine, I can select this option, but as of now I don't have any Windows machine, so let me not select this option and let me click on create plan. Now let me go to the backup plan. So this is the backup plan which I have just created. Now the next thing which I need to do is I need to assign the resources. Now how to assign the resources? For that, what we need to do is we need to go to the backup plan, select the backup plan, and after that what we need to do is we need to click on this resource assignment, and here we need to click on the assign resource. Now here we need to select, like for this demo we are going to use the EC2, so I'm going to give the name like EC2 backup. Next, here I need to select the IAM role. If you already have an IAM role created, you can choose that. If you don't, then you can trust the Amazon to create an IAM role for you. The next part, assign the sources. Now this is something important. Now here we have two options: include all resource type and include specific resource type. So let me go with the second one and let me select this one. Let's suppose my task gets to backup the EC2. So I need to select the EC2. Here I have the option to go with all the instance, or I can select the instances from here. But this is not a recommended way to do the things. Let me tell you why. Because tomorrow when my infra is going to be larger, then what will happen? I need to select all the machines one by one. It is not something that I need to backup all the machines which are running in my environment. I have specific machines for which I need to take a backup, right? Because this service is going to involve a cost. And if I'm going with all the EC2 machine, let's suppose if I have 10 EC2 machine, and if I'm going to take backup of all the 10 EC2 machine, that is going to cost me, right? So it is always recommended that we select the particular machines which really need the backup. So for that, what I'm going to do is I will go with the tag option. So how to go with the tag option? So for that, I need to select the first one, include all resources type. And here we need to give the tag. So let me give key name is backup. Condition is equal to value true. Now what exactly this means is whatever the resources have this key pair assigned, that is only I'm going to take the backup. Other resources, it is not going to take the backup. So let me assign this thing. Continue. Done. Now what I need to do is I need to go to my EC2 console. Here I need to select my machine. So this is my machine. And here I need to go to the tag option, and here we need to add a tag, that is backup is equal to true. Save. Now we need to go back to the AWS backup service. Now here in the backup plan, it is telling me that I have one backup plan, I have one resource assigned. It is also giving me the role ARN and everything. Okay, now what we need to do is we need to take the backup. So how we can take the backup? For that, what we need to do is we need to go to the dashboard, and here we have the option to create on-demand backup. So for which thing I need to take the backup? For EC2, here it is going to show me the instance, because I have assigned a tag to my instance, so it is showing it here. Now the next option, create backup now or customize the backup. So I will go with the create backup now. Retention period is going to be for 1 day. Backup vault, we already have the backup vault, so I'm going to select that. Role, everything, create on them. Now what it is going to do is it is going to take the backup of this instance. Now this backup is going to take some time, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause the video, and once this thing is completed then I will resume. Here we are in the jobs. Let me go to the jobs, and here it is telling me that my backup is completed now, and it is also telling me the instance ID for which I have taken the backup. Now the next thing is we need to go to the backup vault. We need to select our backup, and here we have the image. Now let's suppose I need to restore this backup. So how I can do that? For that I need to go to the backup vault, I need to select this thing, and here in the action we have the restore option. And once I'm going to click on the restore option, it will give me all the detail which I will get at the time of creating the machine. So if I need to change something, I can do that. Let's suppose I need to change the type of the machine, I can do that. It is not going to affect anything. Subnet I'm going to change, so we can click on the restore backup, and what it is going to do is it is going to create a EC2 machine for me. Now this is how you can take a backup of your EC2 instance. You can restore a backup of your EC2 instance. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, hit the like button and do subscribe my channel. Thank you.